What's up, everybody? In this video, I'm just going to show you a quick tutorial on how to set up a Burst wallet and start mining with your free hard drive space. So BurstCoin is kind of attractive right now because it doesn't use GPUs or ASIC miners or CPUs. It uses hard drives, and everybody who has a computer has free hard drive space, and depending on how much free hard drive space you have, can depict on how much BurstCoin you can actually mine. Another thing is, because it uses hard drives, it uses a lot less electricity. Granted, you do need to keep your system up and running, but a hard drive will use a few watts compared to like a few hundred watts for higher end graphics cards and CPUs. So first things first, I'm just going to give you a rundown of what we're going to go over. Downloading the wallet, downloading the blockchain, copying over the blockchain to the correct folder, setting up a new wallet address, plotting hard drives, and setting a reward recipient, and then starting mining. So first things first, you got to go over to burst-coin.org and then download the wallet. If you have a Windows-based system, I would recommend just downloading the Q-bundle, which includes the plotting and mining software. And then also, in the meantime, download the blockchain files. So they're both going to be zip files. Let me go over to the machine that I have them on. And you're going to go over to your downloads. And you're going to see your Q-bundle. You're going to extract that. And then your Burst database that you've also downloaded. I would just wait until this finishes downloading, until you open up the Q-bundle, because this is a much smaller download. And then extract that. You're going to have your Burst database, which you can copy and paste into this folder, which is where it's going to read your blockchain files. And then just go ahead and replace the file or the folder in that, replace the Burst DB folder within your Q-bundle folder, and then open up Burst Wallet. And you're going to be met with this screen, and you'll see down here at the bottom, it's probably going to start synchronizing the rest of the blockchain files as well. And what you want to do is you want to create a new account, and it's going to give you a phrase. So you write down that phrase, keep it in a safe place, and that's also how you log in to your BurstCoin wallet. And you can also copy and paste it onto, you know, a text file, but, you know, it's not the most secure place to keep it by itself. Let's say your computer crashes and then you lose it. So keep it on a physical piece of paper as well, and then you want to go ahead and log in. So this is what you'll be met with. You won't have any transactions, but you will have zero balance and all that other stuff there as well. You can see your Burst address, and this is your public address. It's not private or anything like that. If you want to donate Burst coins to me, you can go ahead and send Burst coins to that. I would appreciate it. And as you can see, BurstCoin is kind of attractive because it's so cheap, and it's actually pretty easy to mine right now. I've been mining on it for a few days, and if we go to the pool that I mine on, you can see that I've already mined 9 BurstCoin. I haven't had everything I've had up and running for that long, so I should be able to get about, according to calculators, with 4 terabytes of plotted hard drive space, I should be able to get somewhere between 100 and 150 Burst a month. So that's pretty good if BurstCoin were to shoot up in price like some of the other cryptocurrencies out there. So we've got the miner downloaded, and we're synchronizing our blockchain, and what we need to do now is we need to start a plot. So let's go to tools and then open up plotter, and then we want to choose where we want to keep that plot file. I've already got one that I've set up here as a test. And we also want a numeric account number. So a numeric account number is easy. Just click on this and copy over your numeric account number ID. There'll be two options. Copy your account ID and your numeric ID, and then paste it in here. Select the size of your plot file that you want to choose to make on your hard drive. Now, if this is just a drive dedicated to mining, you don't want to fill up the entire thing. What I found is leaving a couple gigs of space free is helpful. For whatever reason, I filled up an entire 4 terabytes drive with just a plot file, and it wasn't mining properly. I wasn't getting what I think I should have been getting off of a 4 terabyte plot. Now, since it's an empty drive, you can have your start and on set 0, and then click start mining. Or you can first choose how many threads of your CPU. Like, I have a quad-core CPU on this. I don't want to be slamming the processor 100% because then the computer would be super slow, so I use 3, and then 1 gig of memory. Also, there are GPU miners out there, but this is just to get it going with the built-in CPU plotter. I'm sorry, did I say miners? I meant plotters. Just to get it going with a CPU plotter, and you can click start plotting. That does take some time, so plan ahead. Plotting a 1 terabyte drive with my first gen i3 took about a day and a half, almost 2 days. So I had to make sure my computer wasn't going to reboot for Windows updates or anything like that within that time. Otherwise, you pretty much have to start all over again. Make sure you check your power settings and make sure it doesn't go to sleep or anything like that as well. So once the plot is finished and once your blockchain is fully synchronized, you need to set a reward recipient for the pool you're going to be mining on. So for me, I went and selected my predetermined pool as fastpool.info, and you can get the information that you need from the fastpool.info website. So this is the recipient, the reward recipient address that you want to put in there, and then you'll copy that into your pool account right there. And then we can check our reward recipient here since we've already done that. And you'll see it's fastpool.info. You do have to pay 1 burst coin to set that reward recipient. And you can't start mining until you set a reward recipient. So how do you get your first burst coin? Well, what you can do is you can go over to a faucet, input your burst address, complete the CAPTCHA, and you'll get a burst coin. This one is good. I used this one myself. Faucet.burstpay.net, and that'll get you with a registered reward recipient. So then you can start mining once you have your plot files up and running and everything as well. So let's see here. We've set that, and then you'll get your 1 burst coin, and it does cost 1 burst coin to set a reward recipient. I also changed my worker's name here, and I set my reward recipient. So I had to find 2 sources for burst coin. Anyways, I did get it set up. I did get it working. I do have my 3 plot files. So now we can start mining. And we'll allow that to make changes. The same thing will pop up when you select your miner. And hopefully we'll get a deadline reached as well. So the deadline limit for this pool, I believe, is 80 million, as you can see, seconds. So that's, I believe, 1 year. So as long as you reach any deadline under 1 year, it'll recognize that deadline, send the deadline that you found back to the pool, and if you're determined to have met that deadline, you'll get to mine that block and get the reward from that block. So that's pretty much in a nutshell how that works. And you can go to your pool's webpage and keep track of how much burst you're actually mining, how many rounds you've completed, the shares that you have, and your best deadline. So I've been mining 30 rounds, and so far today, it's not total rounds how many I've done lifetime, but so far I've been able to accumulate 9.37 burst. It does pay out at 50 burst. So that's why I don't have anything showing up in my wallet here yet. I won't get anything showing up in here until I get to 50 burst. And since the transaction will have like a 1 burst cost, I should get a minimum of 49 burst that shows up in my wallet. So that's burst coin mining in a nutshell. I've seen some other videos where they show how to set up burst coin mining, but they don't cover the reward recipient, which is kind of important. So I thought I'd go through and show you that. in a really quick tutorial. So the miner's running, blockchain is synchronized, and I'm running a local wallet. So yeah, that's pretty much how everything works. And once you get it transferred to your wallet, you can then transfer it onto an exchange or something and trade for other coins or cash it out if you'd like. I do plan on donating 10 burst to this faucet once I do get my first payment, whenever that's going to be. So yeah, if you plan on mining as well, just keep in mind that these faucets also help introduce new miners, so possibly donate to them as well. It really helps out the burstcoin community. And if you'd like, if you already are a burstcoin miner, go ahead and send me some burstcoin, because that would be pretty cool. And as always, like, subscribe, and have a good day. Thanks for watching.